Good morning, students. Today we are going to start the new topic in our previous chapter, that is chapter 2, from trade to territory. So far we have completed all the important policy decisions of the Britishers and what were the major administrative changes which they brought when they started ruling India. Now this is the last topic of that chapter, the company army. Now as you can see from this picture, look at the dress of the Britishers. This is the dress of the British army. They were wearing the knee breeches, then the boot and the hat, and in their hand, just see, they are carrying the musket. They are carrying the musket, that is the heavy rifle they are carrying, and look at the attitude they are having. And just besides them there is one Indian one also. They used to call the Indian people as Indian sipoi. The sipoi is the English version of Hindi word sipahi. Now if we compare the two armies, what kind of army was existing in India before the comings of Britishers. If you will see the mighty Mughals, the Mughal army was mainly composed of cavalry and infantry. Cavalry is the trained soldiers on the horseback, you must have seen in the movie, and infantry is we can say the foot soldiers. They were given training in archery, that is Tir Andazi, and the use of the sword. The cavalry dominated the army and the Mughal state did not feel the need to have a large professionally trained infantry. The rural areas had a large number of armed peasants and the local jamindars often supplied the Mughals with paddle soldiers. Now see what was happening there. The Mughal army, it was basically composed of the cavalry, means soldiers who were riding the horses, and the infantry, that is the people, soldiers who were moving on their feet. You must have seen it. Now they were trained in the traditional warfare, that is how to use the archery, Tir Andazi, and the use of the sword. Unhe talwar baji sikhai jati thi, unhe tir dhanush chalana sikhaya jata tha. Aur mainly jo Mughal की आर्मी थी उसमें जो मैक्सिमम लोग होते थे वो कैवलरी के होते थे, और जो इन्फेंट्री होती थी यानी वो फुट सोल्जर्स जो पाँव से चल के लड़ाई करते थे, उन फुट सोल्जर्स के लिए कोई भी प्रोफेशनल, कोई उनको स्पेशल ट्रेनिंग नहीं दी जाती थी. बल्कि जो लोकल ज़मींदार थे तो जब राजा को ज़रूरत पड़ती थी सिपाहियों की, तो वो जो है अपने पीजेंट्स को, यानी जो उनके अंडर जो किसान या लैंडलेस लेबरर्स या पीजेंट्स काम करते थे उनको वो भेज दिया करते थे. लेकिन बाय द 18th सेंचुरी मेनी न्यू किंगडम्स इमर्ज लाइक बनारस, अवध. नाउ दे स्टार्टेड रिक्रूटिंग पीजेंट्स इनटू देयर आर्मीज एंड ट्रेनिंग देम एज प्रोफेशनल सोल्जर्स. The East India Company adopted the same method when it began recruitment for its own army, which came to be known as the Sepoy Army. Now, after the 18th century, Mughal Empire started to decline, and many new kingdoms emerged. One of such kingdoms were Awadh and Banaras. Now, the rulers of Awadh and Banaras, they started giving the professional training to the peasants. They were not like the way earlier that jamindars were supplying the peasants in case of war to the king. Now they were recruited, they were trained the way now army people are. And when East India Company came to India and started ruling Bengal, they also started the same procedure. They also began recruitment for its own army, and they were calling that army Sepoy Army. Now just see what was the changes in the warfare technology from the 1820s. East India Company started to use musket and matchlocks. What is this musket, beta? Musket, a heavy gun used by the infantry soldiers. I have shown you in the picture also. And matchlock. Matchlock is an early type of a gun in which the powder was ignited by the match. Okay. Soldiers were started to be given European style training, drill and discipline that regulated their life far more than before. Now these soldiers, the East India Company soldiers, the sipahis were started to be given training the way they were training the way European army were getting the training, the same kind of a training and the same kind of a drill and discipline they also have to follow. They started maintaining more discipline. So, you know, they adopted the military culture of the European. In the early 19th century, the British began to develop a uniform military culture. Soldiers were increasingly subject to European-style training, drill, and discipline that regulated their life far more than before. But often this created problems also, because Britishers always ignored caste and community feeling when they were giving training to the professional soldiers, even during the recruitment. Now, could individuals so easily give up their caste and religious feeling? Because India is a country which is from the very beginning is dominated by the casteism, by the religious sentiments and all. So it was not an easy thing for Indians to give up all these things. Could they see themselves only as soldiers and not as a member of communities? So in such circumstances, ultimately what happened? They reacted to the changes in their lives and in their identity. And ultimately, the discontentment, the dissatisfaction among the sipahis because of the ignorance of Britishers of their religious sentiment and their culture, they ultimately rose and fought in the revolt of 1857, and it is famously known and Britishers always called that revolt of 1857 as sipahi mutiny, because the soldiers refused to use the cartridges used by the cartridges given by the Britishers. ईस्ट इंडिया कंपनी के बारे में अगर हम देखें तो 1820 से काफ़ी सारे चेंजेस आए क्योंकि द कंपनी आर्मी जो है वो अपने आप को चेंज करने लगी सिचुएशन के हिसाब से. नाउ जो कंपनी आर्मी थी उसकी ट्रेनिंग जो है यूरोपियन स्टाइल में होने लग गई. वो लोगों को उस तरह से जो है यूनिफॉर्म भी पहनना होता था, उसी तरह से डिसिप्लिन में भी रहना होता था. और ब्रिटिशर्स जब रिक्रूटमेंट करते थे, सिपाहियों की भर्ती करते थे, तो उस समय वो भर्ती करने वक्त किसी का कास्ट या रिलीजन नहीं देखते थे. इवन जब वो ट्रेनिंग देते थे तो उस समय भी वो कास्ट एंड रिलीजियस फीलिंग्स को इग्नोर करते थे. तो इंडिया एक ऐसी कंट्री थी जिसमें कास्टिज्म बहुत ज़्यादा डोमिनेंट था, रिलीजियस फीलिंग्स बहुत ज़्यादा डोमिनेटेड थे. तो उन लोगों के लिए कास्ट और रिलीजन को भूल जाना इस प्रकार था जैसे खुद की आइडेंटिटी को भूल जाना, और अल्टीमेटली ये एक बहुत बड़ा कारण बना रिवॉल्ट ऑफ 1857 का. ओके, थैंक यू.